My project is called as Unmanned All-Terrain Vehicle. So it's basically, it can be divided into three projects. First project is the fact that it's all-terrain, meaning that a full suspension system was implemented, designed and implemented on the project. So basically it should operate on all terrains. The second project is that it's autonomous, which means that you can give it the GPS coordinate of a certain location, and it then calculates the required angle, the required distance that it needs to travel, and goes to that point. The third project is that when it sees an obstacle in front of it, it then asks the user for his input, meaning that it gives the user two options, either to avoid that obstacle or to climb that obstacle. What I started with was drawing plenty of sketches and trying to imagine how it will look like. I was just trying to develop an idea which is feasible, which have applications in the real life, which is beneficial and can be achieved within the very short semester, which is around 4 months. I faced a lot of challenges in terms of programming, since I don't have a lot of knowledge in that field. I've been studying mechanical engineering for the past 4 years, so when I got involved in programming and using microprocessors and microcontrollers, it was a huge step for me. I had some time to catch up during the summer vacation, which was useful, so that once the semester started, I'm already well ahead. Now that the project is done, I feel satisfied with what I have achieved. I can say that work, or the amount of work that you put into something and then finally you can see it coming true, this makes a project successful or not. If you work hard on something and finally you achieve it, and you achieve almost exactly what you had in mind, then I can say, the amount of success of this project is way beyond what I have thought.
The idea of the project is significant because it's an unmanned autonomous vehicle that can be remotely controlled, and in these days with the development of artificial intelligence and robotics, this is a significant area of research. Let's say there are safety concerns and you would like remote access and control to an area that you would like to collect information or material or samples. Obviously, this is very popular in space applications. You know, it opens prospects, and also it has the capability of obviously it's a vehicle that can lift itself and climb obstacles. So in a way, it also raises awareness about accessibility issues for disabled people, and raises awareness about providing solutions to these issues of accessibility and mobility for disabled people.
I want to congratulate Mualam for doing an exemplary work. Basically, his work is a combination of mechanical and electrical, and being a mechanical engineer, I just get admired about this project. So being a mechanical engineer, within the 4 months, he was able to adapt to the electronic principles. He learned all the circuits by himself, and the way how he approached the project and the way how he troubleshooted the project, it's a commendable work, whatever he has done it. And if you look into this electronics, gadgets and other equipments or accessories, whatever he has done, he has a complete diagnostic feature which he has applied to himself, and his each and every step is having a professional approach. And as far as the application is considered, this vehicle can be extended in any kind of applications, whatever is there.
So even though I'm studying mechanical engineering, and I was not exposed to any sort of electronics during my studies, my project involves a lot of electronics, although I didn't study electronics. So the moral behind that is that if you're interested in something, and if you want to do it, and you have the passion that would drive you to complete it, then why not? You can always learn by yourself. You can always achieve by yourself. And as long as you have that energy that drives you to complete it, then you'll be able to do it. Since I managed to do it, then you'll be able to do it.